The Skin Cancer Foundation says that to lower the risk of skin cancer, everybody older than 6 months should use sunscreen every day, not just when lying on a beach or jogging in the midday sun. But Ali Rogin is back to tell us that today's sunblock in America is full of ingredients that are decades old and increasingly obsolete.
The last time the Food and Drug Administration approved any new active ingredients for sunscreen that helped to block our skin from ultraviolet rays was 1999. In the past few years, some new laws have sought to expedite the regulatory process for sunscreen, but many consumers, industry leaders, and dermatologists are frustrated by the slow pace. On social media, skincare influencers and everyday users are spotlighting just how far behind they feel American sunscreens are. It's even got the attention of New York Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
U.S. sunscreens are far behind the rest of the world. I was in South Korea earlier this year, and it is so clear how far advanced the rest of the world is on sunscreen.
Here to discuss the state of American sunscreen is Dr. Rita Linkner, a board-certified dermatologist. Dr. Linkner, thank you so much for joining us. We just heard Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez talking about how far superior brands in South Korea, but also, of course, in Europe and other parts of the developed world. Why is it that American sunscreens are so far behind?
So you hit the nail on the head. It's been since 1999 that a new UV filter has been approved here in the United States. And to back up a little bit, what is a UV filter? So it's actually the chemical ingredient in the sunscreen, which is protecting our skin from UV light. And just to look at the sheer numbers globally, they're just much larger pool of options that manufacturers can draw from, which helps the consumer because there are just more products out there that protect a wider range of UV light. In Europe, there are 29 approved UV filters. Here in the United States, we have 16. And to break it down even further, looking at specifically UVA light, which is what ages our skin, in Europe, there are 9 UV filters for UVA light. Here in the United States, we only have 4.
So how does that translate to actual protection when we talk about if you're putting on sunscreen that you bought in America versus putting it on in other parts of the world?
So in the United States, sunscreen is regulated as an over-the-counter drug, and that's been happening since 1978. When you look at Europe, sunscreens are regulated as cosmetics there. They do not require human clinical data in order to get approved. However, their standards for UVA filter approval is more robust than what we have here in the United States. There is a suggestion that the FDA is going to change the UVA approval standards here in the United States, which will bring up the parity level to be equivalent as to what is now, you know, normal process in Europe. So we're all kind of holding our breath, waiting for the FDA to make these types of changes.
And I think to the average person, when you hear extensive regulation to make sure that these substances that we're putting on our skin are safe, you think that's a good thing. But why is it that it seems like, from what you're saying, these other markets have found a better balance between safe ingredients and the best products for skin protection?
So it's interesting. Europe does not require human data in order for their filters to be approved. But in the studies that have come out since their filters have hit the market, there's very little data to suggest that it's in any type of way endangering the consumer there. There's very little dermal absorption, skin allergy reactions, irritant reactions. So the less regulation there in Europe has given them more options. But again, it hasn't come with any significant data to suggest that that's putting the consumer there in any type of harm. So there's an exciting European filter. It's called Triasorb B that covers into visible light, specifically blue light. We're learning more and more every day about how blue light ages the skin, affects melasma, rosacea, other dermatologic issues. So yes, it'll protect you against, you know, skin cancer and all of that, but these bells and whistles, the new technology, the savvier filters that are coming out in Europe, I'd love to see those start to now come to fruition on the American manufacturing side as well.
Bottom line, if you're putting on American sunscreen, what is your risk compared to somebody who's putting on sunscreen from a different market? And also, what should people who only have access to the American sunscreen market be doing to help protect themselves to the fullest extent?
let's be clear, you're safe in using American products. It's not as though your skin is at any additional risk. I just want to be very clear about that. Everyone should be using sunscreen 365 days a year. You want to make sure that you're applying it on everything that's exposed. You want to make sure you're reapplying it every 2 hours. Ideally, you're using an SPF level that's between a 30 and a 50. Try to avoid high intensity sun exposure between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Wearing a wide brimmed hat and clothing with UPF protection that covers exposed areas. These are all additional modifiable behaviors we can all take on. Skin cancer is the most common type of cancer here in the United States. You want to be making all of these good choices when you're outdoors as we come from summer and go into the fall as well.
Dr. Rita Linkner, board certified dermatologist, thank you so much for breaking this down for us.
Thank you so much for having me, Allie.